I showed you a shoot on location with one of these, and a studio shoot with the Fuji EFX20s. Now, I want to like push this a little bit further, saying it's not really about these lights. You know, I'm not doing these videos for these strobes in particular. Yeah, I do love them. Yeah, they're a great little light. They don't offer much. You know, the new Godox Juniors, I think, would do the same thing. They're a little bit larger, obviously, but I just want to show you that you don't have to wait until you have great studio gear or better or the best gear to just shoot and have fun. The shoot I did is I used one of these on the camera, one of these off, you know, put it in the remote mode. It's just optical slave, if you will. You know, it sees the light flash and it flashes too, kind of a thing. And you know, this is, you know, our first wireless was this kind of thing where it was just an optical slave. We used them on the old boxes. We'd get a plug-in where the sync would go and it had an optical slave on it, would just fire the flash, and we thought we were the coolest in the world because we had wireless flash. But they still work today, obviously. And here's the thing, like when we were going through transition, you know, we would go to events or location stuff and everybody would have their point and shoots. Well, the flashes on the point and shoots would set these off in optical. So it was like, it was a pain. Every time you see somebody bring up their point and shoot, you would cover the optical part of the flash so that it wouldn't go off, because you'd be wasting battery power. Or if somebody was really ticking you off every time you put up your camera to take a shot, they would jump in and shoot. So every time they would take a photo, we'd point the flash at theirs and it would always be blown out, because I know it was mean. Anyway, so I just wanted to play and have fun and say, listen, whether it's these or, you know, regular full-size strobes, like, you know, the $80 ones you get off Amazon, the speed lights, you can have fun with these and just, you know, on camera, one off, play, have fun. This is a great way to learn lighting, and it's a great way to like be reactive to situations, because, you know, this is not perfect by any means. And you have to work at your photo sometimes with, you know, just, these are bare. There's no modifiers, there's nothing. It's just bare flash on camera, bare flash off camera, you know, and work the light to see what you can do and create better light. But it's great practice. So when later, if you do get bigger and better strobes, it'll be a walk in the park compared to you using these. But anyway, I really quick shoot. Here they are, the two tiny little flashes. By the way, the on-camera flash I used prior to the shoot, so it started blinking, I would say like 90% through the shoot. I did get a lot of photos out of it. I did stay at 1/64th and 1/32nd on each. I think the off-camera was mostly at 1/64th. The on-camera, you know, it was right in front of me, so it was easy just to switch one to the other. But, you know, the batteries went 90% through the shoot. I got a lot of shots out of it, and it was just two AAA batteries. The remote flash lasted through the whole thing, so anyway, that's it. Enjoy the shoot really quick. If you have any questions, leave them below. But go out and have fun with these, with whatever flashes you have. Don't go out and buy these. You know, unless you get a good deal on them, because these new were $199. I think they sell for $400 now, which is insane, but thanks. So this is a pretty easy setup. I literally have one of the flashes, which is smaller than the MagMod shoe grip there, to the model's right, and I have one on camera. That's it. It's simple, straightforward setup. And it's kind of beautiful light. You know, I did a little vignetting on this, obviously, but it's quick and easy. And like I said, this is something fun to do to hone your skills, to get better at what you do. Because these lights, she has a fan going. She wanted her hair blown on this one. That's why she's acting a little crazy. Anyway, these lights are harsh, and they're kind of hard to control a little bit, but getting used to something like this will make life so much easier for you when you do get bigger lights or better modifiers. But what's nice about this is literally, I mean, you can really say this is a studio in your pocket because these two little flashes will fit in your pocket. Now, I have it on a stand because I literally wrenched my neck the night before so I couldn't hold it. Otherwise, I'd literally be holding that second flash in my hand and just outreaching my arm and shooting in that way. But, you know, I can get a little bit more shadowing and depth with it on a stand. But can you imagine, like, the little tiny stand that you would need for this? And I did order one of those LumCube stands. I got to show you that. I'll do it in an upcoming video. But anyway, so, you know, you're going to get shadows in the background. If you don't want them, pull them away from the background more. I kept everything at, I think, 1/64th on both. Every once in a while, like back here, I'm back a little further from her. So the on-camera flash I put at 1/32nd. And this is it. This is the simple lighting. And if you turn down the flash on the camera and then turn it up on that. Now, these, I didn't show you her on the ground because of the outfit. I didn't want anything popping out or showing or whatever. So I'm just showing you the two images from this outfit on the ground, you know, just out of respect for the model. But you can see that, you know, these two little flashes did this. Now I'm an ISO 200 on this. And this is, at this point, this is where my batteries are going, okay, we can't, you know, we can't charge this anymore. So I had to swap out the batteries and that. And I'm just using the loop batteries, the rechargeables. Here she is on the ground again, and you can see the shadow behind her, but the light's gorgeous. I mean, you know, the camera and the flash on the camera is like doing that fill, and this is, you know, that one, the other one's the main, you know, because I have it turned up just a little bit more for the on the floor shots, but the lighting's gorgeous. It came out beautiful. I love the look. And remember, this is two little tiny little flashes, and you can get $99 or $89 flashes or get used $50 flashes. You know, just check to make sure they have the optical remote on them. And a lot of the flashes do. And you don't even need a remote then. You just throw one on your camera, one on the side on a stand, and you're ready to go. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed the shoot. And like I said, the images aren't the best, but they were fun. And I just wanted you to see how I set things up and how I shot this. And it was a no-brainer. It was not thinking. It was, you know, just moving lights and honing your skills kind of a thing. But enjoy, and if you have any questions, leave them below. Thanks again for watching.